Hey everybody, this is Ori from MasterWeb, and today I'm going to introduce to you one of the most important apps that any Shopify store can have, which is the Rewind app. We at MasterWeb, our company, we service a lot of different companies, ranging from very small businesses to larger and to very big enterprise businesses. And one of the things that is in common to them is we all make sure that all of our clients have a backup plan in case they need to restore something. So let's talk about it a little bit. So first of all, every store online is a whole business that's running, and you want to make sure it's running smooth. So if you have a problem, you can always restore and go back to it, right? Someone, for example, one of your admins, one of your customer service deletes maybe a customer, or you change the price by mistake of a product, or you edit a theme, or a developer makes a mistake. You, with Rewind, you always have a backup. And it's one of the most important underrated apps that exist there from a developer and an integrator side, which is what we do. But every business should have it. So you always want to have a backup and a backup plan in case something happens, right? Maybe you got hacked, someone deleted something, an angry employee, or in most cases, some kind of human error. So Rewind is very, very simple. I want to show you a little bit and show you what's going on. It's really simple. So we have a test site right here called Freeware 21, which we've been making some videos for you guys on the YouTube channel. And so what we did is we installed the app and we went to Rewind. We installed the app, and I'm going to put this URL, everything in the comments. Okay, so what is going on here? So what this system does very simply is it goes and it backs up all of your information here. So it backs up your products, your articles, your blogs, your themes. You see things like some settings, like shipping zones, and most importantly, orders and products and your themes, because those are things that are more common that someone's going to make a mistake or someone deleted something like that. Very, very simply, every single day, this app goes and fetches all the data they can from Shopify and it backs it up here. And then also you can do it on demand. So for example, if I made a big change, I can also click and back up everything. And so everything is listed right here. And now I can see, for example, let's show you an example that a product was deleted right here. I can see here it was deleted. And I can see I can look at older versions. For example, this product existed on June 6th, but on June 12th, it's not existed because it was deleted. So I can restore it. If I deleted it by mistake, I can actually restore it, and I have all the information. So this is the basic information, and I can see all the versions the system had, and I can also see the source code. What that means, this is a summary of the data of this product in particular, and if I see source code, I can see more detail about the product, okay? So let me show you another example. Let me go here to product updated. So I had a product before. So I had a product right here on the left, and it has some product information. And let me go here to check out some versions. And for example, I can see that on June 11th, I can see that these variants, for example, this one, this product, you know, in size 7 black was $140, but I actually changed it to $133. So how do you see this? What I typically would do, I go to the source code and I'd look at the highlighted sections right here. There's going to be a highlighted section. Let's go here, scroll down to see things that have changed from the current version to the version that you've selected here. For example, on, let's say, June 6th. Okay. And then I can see here, let me scroll down. Okay. I can see that the price of this specific SKU, right? This SKU CO2 Black 7 used to be 140 in this date on the 6th, but now is 133. So I can easily track the differences. And most importantly, if I want to restore this, for example, I want to go and restore June 6th, all I'm going to do here is click here, wait a few minutes, and then it'll be restored and live. So this is a way for me to not just see the changes, but also to fix them and restore them. So I have a backup of all of this. By default, Rewind makes a backup for 1 year, 365 days. You can go back and everything, and it's really, really nice. So that's really simple. So just to show you what's going on. So I can go and see all the changes that were done on a new article, you know, basically creation of something, edit of something, delete of something. That's exactly what this is. So for example, article on your blog, products, orders, etc. So you see a blog updated, a theme was updated, maybe some code was updated, my menu was updated, etc. And things like order was created and order was updated, maybe order was shipped or order address was changed. Now, in addition to me checking one by one and then restoring one by one, I can also do bulk restores, which I can specify. For example, I want you to restore all of the, let's say, products, you know, or customers or any of the things that are here by a certain date. I would select the date, for example, yesterday at a certain time, and it would take all the information here based on the latest versions I have for that date and restore it. Now, once you restore, typically it takes time, especially if you do a lot of things. Some things will take a few minutes. Some things will take a few more minutes or hours, depending on the size of your catalog and orders and et cetera, et cetera. That's it. Really, really simple. So in summary, two things I want to talk about. Number one is, you should consider having a backup plan, which is a great app that's very affordable. Let's look at the cost itself. Let's see how I do this. So subscription, and I go here, and this was a video we have here. So it'll be based on the orders you have per month. So if you have 20 orders a month, 200 or 600 a month, then you'll pay this. So it's either $3, $9, or $39. Strongly suggested you're running a whole business that is supporting your family, you know, etc. So spending a few extra dollars to have a backup plan is going to be very, very good for you. So this is very, very important. And we strongly suggest for you to do this. As developers, AstroWeb, our company, we've seen so many times human mistakes happen. The developer made a mistake with something. They deleted something in the code. They didn't make a backup. Here you have a backup. Admin or customer service deleted something or changed the price wrongly. You can always have a track of what happened a certain day, right? And if you have some issues on the site, you can always backtrack what was done on the back end during those time. And you can always figure out how to solve things a little bit easier for that. That's it. So that's a very simple thing. The last thing, the second thing I wanted to talk about is I'm going to specify this link right here for Rewind. And it's really important to know what they include for what is backed up and actually what is not backed up. So there's a few things that Shopify doesn't give access to the app to back up. So it's really important. And let's just review it really quickly. So what is Rewind backup? Product and product images, customers and customer tags, orders but not backend draft orders, collections, blog post pages, and themes. But things, for example, like products, they don't back up the inventory. That's one thing. And these things right here, menu, store policies, locations, shipping zones, these are backed up but cannot be restored. So you can see the data, but you'd have to manually restore it yourself. These can be backed up and restored. And lastly, there's some things over here that you cannot, the system doesn't have access to based on Shopify requirements or Shopify restrictions, These things like URL redirects are not backed up, so you'd have to make your own backups for those. Other than that, that's it. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about backups, rewinds, how to flow, how to do better flows, better backups, how to have your developer not make less mistakes, et cetera, very important. That's it. Appreciate you guys watching the video. Subscribe, click on the bell, ask questions. We're a community. We're learning together. We're providing more information. Appreciate it, guys. Thanks.